All right, let's go ahead and play first. What do we have here? All right, I think this is a keepable hand. It's got the brick of a Blightsteel Colossus in hand, but I can turn one Duress, I think, since I'm not less worried about Stoneforge, and then I can Preordain into Thoughtseize, do some things. Huh, interesting. So I like seeing this hand, because it's not super disruption heavy. I think, you know, I'm just going to take Mana Drain. My opponent can turn one Batterskull, and that's fine. I'm not worried about racing a turn one Batterskull. So, if I'd let a Thoughtseize, I could have Duressed the Batterskull no matter what. If I'd let a Thoughtseize, it would have been basically the same. I could have also taken the Lotus, but it didn't seem correct. Oh, Deathrite Shaman, sure. Alright, I can just Time Twister now. Opponent's got nothing in hand. I'll give it a turn. I'll cast a Preordain, see if I can hit something good. Oh, I don't want Yawgmoth's Will. Guess I'll keep a land and just go ahead and cast Mana Vault here. I don't think I cast... Again, I think I could wait on the Time Twister, since it will give my opponent a new set of cards. Ooh, Ancestral Recall. All right. If I get Thoughtseize now, I'm going to be pretty unhappy, because it'll make it very hard to win. If my opponent just drew counters off of it, I can Thoughtseize and then cast Time Twister, and that's not too bad. But what am I hoping to draw this turn? I guess Lotus is still a pretty good draw. Opponent is casting a Jace. All right, well, my opponent's draw has improved dramatically from the opening hand of Batterskull, Mana Drain, Lotus lands, but I think I'm still in okay shape here. I'm going to have to Thoughtseize first, because if it gets Force of Will, if the Time Twister rather gets Force of Will, then I'm pretty dead, but I think that's... Oh, maybe I'm not going to have to Thoughtseize, because that's a Mana Vault. All right, opponent's got one card in hand. All right, well, it's not untapped, I'm already untapped Mana Vault. Casting Time Twister, the question is, do I want to play my land first? I think I do. The only thing it potentially costs me is Talarian Academy, and I think that's a narrow enough option. Well, this is a pretty good hand. Wow, this is a very good hand. I've cast two spells so far. I guess I can lead with Time Walk, because if it resolves, then I've got a lot more options. All right. Given that Time Walk has resolved, so I've got two spells. Opponent's pretty tapped out. I can Ritual, DT. So I've two mana. I can go up to five mana. I can DT, Will, that doesn't work. So let's just... I could Brainstorm, but then I have to put things back. Let's just Brainstorm next turn. Took my Time Walk turn. I could also actually just DT now. Actually, yeah, DTing now seems better. If my opponent forces Demonic Tutor, then I'll recalibrate. But I think saving the mana is probably worth it. And I think Yawgmoth's Will is going to be good enough here. So let's untap, take one. Go to 14. I think my opponent would have forced Time Walk. That was the reason I did that. Maybe that was greedy, but... Alright, let's Brainstorm here. Still wouldn't mind finding a Duress, but if I don't. I don't think I need Bargain or Vamp at this point. Let's see. Oh, I'm going to play a fetch land, so I have four cards in graveyard. Ritual. Oh, five cards of Brainstorm, so I have seven. I'm trying to see if I can... So four... Yeah, I'll have enough mana now that I want to be able to hard cast Force of Will in case my Yawgmoth's Will gets threatened here. All right. I can only get Island now, but I think that's all right. Black. Ritual. Big Ritual. So 8 mana. And let's just make sure I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spells. Yeah, so I could have tapped for some colorless, but I've got so much mana it doesn't really matter. Yeah, so plenty of spells. It's Demonic Tutor. Get a Tendrils of Agony. And I guess just cast Tendrils. Don't really need to do anything else, since that's 10 spells cast before Tendrils. Alright. Oh wait, that's 22. Because my opponent has Batterskull. Oh, that's nice. I was just not even looking. Alright, well, let's figure out a way to win this game through my buffoonery. And that's casting probably Time Walk and then Time Twister. And Time Twister. Yeah, so I could have easily won this, but instead decided not to. That being said, I'm not just dead. Let's just take an extra turn. Tendrils is gone, but I'm at 35. I've got a Jace now and Blightsteel Colossus. So if I had a blue source left over last turn, I actually could have won that turn. But even though I don't, look, I've just got to make things exciting. That's all. Let's go ahead and Thoughtseize my opponent. Steel Sabotage. Ancestral Mox Emerald. Let me see. So I've got the one Tendrils is gone. Wow, that was horrendous. So I've got the Blightsteel Colossus, but that's going to be tough. I've got to basically find Time Vault and Voltaic Key. What do I care about the most out of those cards? I think I actually care about Steel Sabotage the most here. Land. Jet. I guess now is when I play the Academy. Tap Academy. Cast Jace. Brainstorm with Jace, because I have Tinker to shuffle with. Alright, find Time Vault. Look, just because I wanted to make this a little bit more exciting doesn't necessarily mean anything else. Alright, let's tinker away Mana Vault. Let's get Voltaic Key, and I still have the Blightsteel ready, and actually I even have Jace to win the game with, so let's take an extra turn. Alright. Well, this deck's great. Even though I tendrils my opponent down to one for just basically no reason, I also assembled a Vault Key for the win. So